When we're going through town, we're probably gonna get broken up a little bit. When we hit the Glen Highway, headed out, we'll slow down to about 45 in the slow lane until the last person catches up, and then we'll speed up a little bit. But so expect to be broken up just a bit, but it's pretty easy to get onto the highway. We're only going about 3 hours today. And then Cynthia is gonna go ahead of us when we stop at the gas station or diesel station so that she can scout out our next spot to make sure it's not flooded out. If it is, then we'll have an alternate spot that we're gonna go to. So she'll come back, let us know, and then we'll tell you which one we're gonna stay at. And then from there, you can go into the town of Talkeetna, do whatever you wanna do, explore, whatnot, and have fun, okay? If we go to our alternate spot, that'll be Petersville Road, and that's actually a trail for off-roading, which is a lot of fun. So those who wanna explore the backcountry a little bit on the south side of Denali, that'll be an opportunity for you to do that. Or you could actually do that instead of going to Talkeetna if you want to. We'll give you directions if we end up at the river. So be flexible, have fun, and enjoy the not cold and rain. There's a couple options. It's all dead end, so you can't get lost out there. You can get stuck. So there's several water crossings, and it's a good time. It's a lot of fun back there.
You gotta go check camp.
I have to go pee.
After you go pee?
After I go pee and get something to eat.
Sounds good. We'll wait for you.
Okay.
I drove about 5 miles up the road from Talkeetna and trying to scout it out because we heard a rumor that this part is washed out. I didn't see anybody down by the river, so we'll see what it looks like. Thank you. this is accessible. Wings and Whales, do you copy? So I'm not able to get Jim on the radio. I know he went to the bathroom, and I don't have cell phone service right here. I do further down. So I'm going to turn around and go back and let them know that they can get in here. So Jim was able to call, and he's going to stop and get some groceries at Cubby's. And I'm just going to hang out here and check it out, see what the mosquitoes look like. It looks like we have this whole area to ourselves. I like to be further down towards the end. We'll go check it out. Wild all of this wood out here. It was not like this last year. This says a lot about the winter that we had. I don't think the vans would really like this part too much. So I think I'll go down here and take a look, but I think I'm going to turn around and go back towards the bridge. Get back here.
What are they doing?
Here's your key. Let's look at the rear.
Then Winnebago says, hey, we're putting all this stuff in the rear.
Huh, okay.
Yeah.
Don't be in the video.
I'm not
going to
be in the video.
You can be in it.
I don't want to be in the video.
Okay.
So located the four factory Phillips head screws on the inner fender, yada yada. Ass backwards.
This one, this one, this one, and this one. Look at that. That one that they sell for light bulbs, they actually use this to put that whole piece will come off the plate, and then this can go in place.
How was your drone flight?
Wait till you see the shot I just got. It was impressive.
Great.
I'm excited.